Hey guys.
So I wanted to talk a little bit about the inner child, the golden child archetype. A living childlike spirit that is within us all. Like a lot of people talk about inner child work. What is inner child work? And how can we do inner child work? And why do we do inner child work? I suppose is question one. The golden child is essentially the guardian to our treasures within, to our blessings, to our passions, to our gift to the world. My shaman Don Gino would say, everybody is born into this life with a gift. It is up to you to find the gift and cultivate the gift. So, how do we do that? How do we unlock the inner child? How do we open the gates to our blessings, to the treasures within? I think there's often an association with inner child work, quite understandably, that it's where a lot of the pain is stored. When we come into this life, we're pure. We're always pure. The soul is pure. We are complete. We are whole. We've already arrived. The present moment, we're here. And then we're born into the culture. The collective psychosis. The wetiko, the unconscious blind spots, the ignorance, the low vibrational state of consciousness that we're at collectively, which is rising every day as we speak. But we're still, you know, we were raised into ignorance, and as a result of that, the inner child is met with force, a lot of force against it, and we go through our experiences of trauma and just the state of the world, what we go through depending on what parts of the world you're raised into and what it's like, the level of peace, the level of crime, and we don't feel that, and we don't receive guidance, we don't receive teachings, spiritual guidance. There are no conscious leaders, very rare conscious leaders. If you're born into an indigenous tribe in the Amazon, let's say, then you're blessed. But there are no conscious guides, no conscious leaders. And, you know, our parents do our best, you know, at the level of consciousness they're at. Everybody around us does their best when we're suffering, when we're in pain, when the world is coming down on us and all we can do is cry. If let's say like I was bullied a lot of my childhood, I was bullied, and went to a boarding school, private boarding school, and just a lot of bullies, very tough school. There was no niceness, nobody was nice to me, and the teachers weren't really supportive. They were kind of like, they were worse, like they were just as bad, really, some of them. Like I was once pulled, grabbed by the neck and slammed into a wall, and I was trying to explain to him why I did what I did, to explain to him, like, hey, like, that actually that was a totally fair enough thing for me to do. And I tried to explain it, and he just shouted at me and wouldn't give me a word. And there's just been so many times when that's happened, and I wasn't able to feel my feelings, I wasn't able to deal with it, and so, you know, I suppressed it. And so we've all done that in our own ways, not being able to fully be as we are. We've had to censor ourselves, we've had to mold ourselves to fit into our surroundings. And we carry a lot of pain, we carry a lot of anger, we carry a lot of whatever it is that you went through, whatever treacheries you went through, that's left a mark on you, and you hold that, you know? And it's the inner child that holds it. And so when we turn to the inner child, it can be really hardcore. It can be, you know, it can be darkness for days, weeks, months, years. It can be excruciating. It can be despairing. But it is crucial to learn to be there for these parts of ourselves, because it's yourself, it's you. It's a part of you that's crying out for help. And we tend to do that externally. We cry for help, often in passive, aggressive ways. You know, we hold on to things to make things better again. But when we turn our gaze inward and really go to these parts of us that are hurting, and really, really, really showing, not only saying, not only looking in the mirror, having a conversation with this part of yourself, whatever means of dialoguing you embody with the inner child, with the golden child within you, because my inner child, I don't know about you guys, but my inner child is very, very skeptical, is very, very low on trust in people and things, and he's very careful. So if I'm saying to myself, hey, I'm here, like, I'm really, really here, like, trust me, like, it's not as simple as that, you know. It's a rebuilding of a relationship, it's a reparenting of the inner child, and that takes time. The years and years and years of abuse, and you're saying that you're here for me now, like, I'm here, like, come on, like, people have been saying that all my life. But we can be there, right? It's hard to be there, it's hard to hold these parts of us that are hurting, and it takes a lot of patience, and it takes a lot of courage, and it takes a lot of strength and a lot of discipline of focus, attuning the mind, mindfulness, not being distracted, being present, embodied. And gradually the inner child rests in that space, begins to trust in the foundations, the holding, the cradle. And gradually the child starts to open up and reveal himself and blossom, and express himself, and memories start to come up, you know, the treasures that we buried long ago to keep it safe from the treacheries of the world, going back to these places, remembering the child, honoring the child, honoring what the child went through, and being there, holding that part of you, you know. Think of all the times that you've been in pain. Just think of all the times that you struggled in your past. Just being with all of that and holding space for that. Like, all of that. You needed somebody. You needed help. You needed guidance. You needed some love. You go back to that place and you give yourself this love that you desired, that you longed for all your life. And just knowing that your future self is doing the same, you know, to this present moment, or to any moment surrounding this moment that are really, really painful. You can be there for you. You're always there. While you are alive, you will always be there. So wherever you go, my guidance is to bring yourself with you and hold yourself. Hold all parts of yourself, all forms of expression. It's not about allowing or permitting the inner child to have a tantrum and, like, go running around the high street, like, screaming at people. It's not about just letting the inner child just, like, do whatever the hell he wants. You know, it's reinstating healthy, mature, sacred boundaries that keep the these parts of us grounded and not making mistakes. And the naivety of the inner child, there's got to be that parental aspect of self that is cultivated in order to be able to hold that golden child. And taking him wherever you go is a blessing. Never forget this part of you. Never leave him goodbye. Okay, he might be really angry. Mine was really angry with me, not only the world, but with me for casting him away into exile to fend for himself in ignorance, in darkness, like Frodo and Sam, like somewhere in the midst of the Middle Earth. Great battle. Somewhere in that is the inner child, is the joy, is the blessings, is the gift. So bring him home. Bring him or her home. It's you. There's nothing to fear. Like, there's nothing to fear. It's you. It's everything you've wanted in everything you've sought. It's there, ready. You are the key. Thank you so much. I hope this message was helpful and beautiful for you. And stay blessed. And yeah, love yourselves. Love that golden child inside of you. Put a crown upon his head. Big love. Aho.